everyone, welcome to PharmaGuide. Today we will continue the topic quality control test of tablets, and we will cover dissolution, drug content and weight variation test in detail. For hardness, friability and disintegration test, please watch my previous video. Dissolution test. Tablet into solution per unit time under a standardized condition is called the dissolution test. Medium used in dissolution testing is purified water, simulated gastric fluid, simulated intestinal fluid or others. Disintegration test only identifies the time required for the tablet to break up under the condition of test, but it does not ensure the drug release into the bulk fluid. Hence, dissolution test is important. After disintegration test, rate of dissolution is directly related to efficacy of the drug. Higher the rate of release, faster the drug will be available into the system to act. Hence, rate of dissolution is directly related to efficacy of the drug. Rate of dissolution is a good index for comparing the bioavailability of two tablet products of the same drug. If the two tablets contain same drug, the tablet that has better dissolution will have the better bioavailability from the other. So, it's a good index for comparing the bioavailability of two tablet products of the same drug. Okay. Factors affecting the dissolution of a tablet. First is disintegration. Disintegration is the important step to drug dissolution in a tablet. Now, first the tablet disintegrates into coarse particles or granules, then into smaller particles, which then dissolves. Hence, disintegration is the first step. Next is particle size of the drug. Now, as the particle size of the drug decreases, effective surface area will increase. Effective surface area is the solid exposed to the dissolution, or surface area is the area of the solid that is exposed to the dissolution. As the effective surface area will increase, faster will be the dissolution rate. Next is solubility and hydrophobicity of the formulations. Aqueous solubility of the drug is a major factor that determines the dissolution rate. Next is type and amount of tablet excipients, disintegrants, binders and lubricants. Now, as faster the disintegration rate, faster will be the dissolution. Next is binder. Hydrophilic binders increases the dissolution rate of the poorly wettable drugs, but in general, if the binder is more harder, the tablet will be produced and slow will be the dissolution. But non-aqueous binders like ethyl cellulose, they decreases dissolution. Next is lubricant. Lubricants are hydrophobic in nature, metallic stearates and waxes, which inhibits the wettability, therefore decreases disintegration and dissolution. But soluble lubricants like sodium lauryl sulfate and carbowaxes, they promote the drug dissolution. Okay, now manufacturing method, compactness of the granulation and compression force used in the tableting. Granulation process generally enhances the dissolution rate of poorly soluble drugs. Okay. Then the compression force. Compression force also influences the density, porosity, hardness, and then the disintegration and dissolution of the tablet. In the conditions that may affect the drug dissolution and release. First is the medium, volume, pH, molarity, co-solvents, added enzymes, surfactants, temperature of the medium, apparatus, hydrodynamics like agitation rate, shape of the dissolution vessel, placement of the tablet in the vessel, sinkers for the floating products and products that sink to the side of the vessel. So these conditions affect the drug dissolution. Okay, now various dissolution apparatus according to USP. First, apparatus 1 is basket apparatus, apparatus 2 is paddle apparatus, apparatus 3 is reciprocating cylinder, apparatus 4 is flow through cell, apparatus 5 is paddle over disc, apparatus 6 is cylinder, apparatus 7 is reciprocating holder. Now, according to Indian Pharmacopoeia, there are two apparatus, apparatus 1 and 2, and it is just opposite to USP. In Indian Pharmacopoeia, first apparatus is paddle type and second is basket type. According to USP, first is basket type and second is paddle type. In USP, first and second, these are used for uncoated, plain coated and capsules for the dissolution testing of uncoated tablets, plain tablets and capsules. Apparatus number 3 and number 4, that is reciprocating cylinder and flow through cell. These are used for the dissolution testing of the extended release and enteric coated tablets. Apparatus 5, 6 and 7, that is paddle over disc, cylinder and reciprocating holder. These are used for the testing of the transdermal patches. Now, according to British Pharmacopoeia, apparatus first is basket type, apparatus 2 is paddle type, third is the flow through cell type. For the transdermal patches, they use disc assembly method, paddle over extraction cell and rotating cylinder. In European pharmacopoeia, for the solid dosage forms, paddle type, basket type, flow through cell apparatus. For the transdermal patches, disc assembly method, cell method, and rotating cylinder. For special dosage forms, they use chewing apparatus. Or for medicating chewing gums, they use the special chewing apparatus. Apparatus 1, basket apparatus according to USP. It consists of a cylindrical vessel. A cylindrical vessel made up of borosilicate glass or any other suitable transparent material. It has a semi-spherical bottom with a capacity of 1000 ml or 1 liter and an inside diameter of 98 to 106 mm. So it's a cylindrical vessel and diameter is 98 to 106 mm. Capacity is 1 liter. Next is a motor. Motor with a speed regulator capable of maintaining the speed of rotation of the basket within 4% of that specified in the individual monograms. Now this motor is fitted with a steering element which consists of a drive shaft and a cylindrical basket at the end which is 23 to 27 millimeter above from the inside bottom of the vessel. Okay. Now this shaft is positioned so that the axis is not more than 2 millimeter at any point from the vertical axis of the vessel. Axis of the shaft and axis of the cylindrical vessel must be same. So the shaft is positioned so that its axis is not more than 2 mm at any point from the vertical axis of the vessel. And rotation should be smooth and with no significant wobble. Now use 40 mm mesh cloth with wire opening of 0.36 to 0.44 mm. This basket consists of a 40 mm mesh cloth. According to IP, this wire thickness of this wire is 0.254 mm in diameter and openings is 0.381 mm square. Okay, according to USP, you can see in the figure, this is also 40 mesh screen and diameter of this wire is 0.25 mm. Length of this basket is 37 plus minus 3 mm. Outer diameter is 25 plus minus 3 mm. Okay. According to IP, the wire thickness is 0.254 mm in diameter and the openings is 0.381 mm square. Agitation speed is 50 to 100 rpm. Usual speed is 50 to 100 rpm. Next part is a water bath. Water bath set to maintain the dissolution medium at a 36.5 to 37.5 degree Celsius. A basket having a gold coating of 2.5 micrometer is allowed for the use in the acidic medium. Acidic medium may corrode the basket, so a gold coating of 2.5 micrometer is allowed. The dosage unit is placed in the dry basket at beginning of each test. What are the products on which we can apply this dissolution basket test with the basket apparatus? Solid, mostly floatings, monodispersed tablets and polydispersed encapsulated beads. Advantages: pH changes during the test can be done. And this apparatus can be easily automated, which is important for the routine investigations. Disadvantages: formulation may clog to 40 mesh screen, small disintegrated particles may fall out, hydrodynamic or dead zone under the basket may be formed, degassing is particularly important, and the mesh can be get corroded by the hydrochloric acid solution. So for this we studied that a gold coating of 2.5 micrometer is allowed for the basket in the acidic medium. Okay, these are the different type of basket: stainless steel, gold plated, Teflon coated, three fin. And the shaft can also be coated, gold plated shaft or Teflon coated shaft. Okay, next is apparatus 2, paddle apparatus. Now the cylindrical vessel and this motor, this is similar to the apparatus 1. Okay, capacity of 1000 ml and internal diameter 98 to 106 millimeter. Speed of rotation of the paddle within 4% of the specified in the individual monographs. Okay, the motor is fitted with a steering element which consists of a driven shaft and a blade forming a paddle. Lower edge of the blade is 23 to 27 millimeter from the inside bottom of the vessel. Apparatus operates in such a way that the paddle rotates smoothly without significant. Okay, water bath is set to maintain dissolution medium at 36.5 to 37.5 degrees Celsius. The paddle, blade and the shaft may be coated with a suitably inert coating. The dosage unit is allowed to sink to the bottom of the vessel before the rotation of the blade. A small loose piece of non-reactive material such as few turns of platinum wire may be attached to the dosage unit in order to prevent the floating of the tablet. Most common operating speed is 50 rpm for the solid oral dosage forms and 25 rpm for the suspensions. Advantages: easy to use and robust, pH change possible. Disadvantages: floating dosage forms, these require sinkers. You can see in the figure, if the dosage form is floating, then V requires a sinker. Then positioning of the tablet is also important. Hydrodynamics are complex. They vary with site of the dosage form in the vessel and therefore may significantly affect the drug dissolution. Coning may occur, you can see in the figure. So this retards the dissolution. Okay, you can see in this figure, this is schematic illustration of forced convection non-sync dissolution testing method, USP paddle apparatus or USP dissolution test method 2. Okay, speed according to USP NF is 25 to 150 rpm. And lower speed is preferred. Shaft, this is 9.5 to 10.5 millimeter in diameter. Lower part may be polyfluorocarbon coated if desired. Centering, plus minus 2 millimeter at all points. Axis of the shaft and axis of the vessel must be same and not more than plus minus 2 millimeter at all the points. Okay, then sampling point midway, between top of the blade and top of the fluid. No closure than 1 centimeter to side of the flask. Okay, this is flask and this is inside diameter is 10 to 10.5 centimeter. This is paddle and position of the paddle is 2.5 plus minus 0.2 centimeter above from the bottom of the vessel. Okay, there is a stainless or glass helix may be attached to the floating dosage forms. Okay. Acceptance criteria for different dosage forms. Conventional release dosage form. D is the amount of dissolved active ingredient specified in the individual monograph expressed as percentage of label content. Okay, dissolution test is done using 6 units or dosage form. These dosage form are run for a specific period of time, sampled and analyzed for the dissolved amount of active ingredient in percentage. This is the first stage called the S1 stage. In S1 stage, each unit is not less than D plus 5%. Okay, each unit should not be less than D plus 5%. This shows that every unit should be above 5% of the specific limit in individual monographs. If any unit is found below this limit, then we have to analyze the sample in S2 stage. Additional 6 units are tested. Average of 12 units, S1 and S2, is equal to or greater than D, and no unit is less than D minus 15. Then it gives us some flexibility to the test results. If any unit is found below D minus 15 or average of all is less than D, then sample is analyzed in S3 stage. Okay, in S3 stage, 12 more units are analyzed for the dissolved active content. At this stage, average of all 24 units should not be less than D. Only 2 units should be less than or below D minus 15 and no unit should be less than D minus 25%. Okay, now acceptance criteria for prolonged release dosage forms. Dissolution test acceptance criteria for prolonged release dosage form is normally expected to consist of at least 3 points. There are 3 specifications or 3 levels. Okay, first specification point is intended to prevent unintended rapid release of the active substance. Unintended release of active substances, dose dumping. So first specification point ensures that there is no dose dumping and it is set after a testing period of 1 or 2 hours or when drug releases 20 to 30%. First specification point is set when the drug releases 20 to 30% or at the time period of 1 or 2 hours. The second specification point defines the dissolution pattern. So it is set when the drug releases almost 50%. And the third specification point, it ensures almost complete release. So it is when a drug is almost 80% released or more than 80% released. The acceptance range for the dissolution pattern at the time interval specified should be defined case by case on the basis of in vitro in. Okay, now we'll try to understand these 3 labels, L1, L2, L3. For this, we consider one example. For example, in 1 hour, release is 10 to 30% range from the prolonged release dosage form. So at L1 level, 6 units are taken and none individual value lies outside each of the stated ranges and no individual value is less than the stated amount at the
final test time. So at L1 stage, all six profiles must be within the range 10 to 30%. And if they are outside, then we will come to L2 level. At L2 level, again 6 units are taken. The average value of the 12 units, L1 plus L2, lies within each of the stated ranges and is not less than the stated amount at the final test time. Okay, now, none is more than 10% of the labeled content outside and none is more than 10% of the labeled content below. So at L2 stage, 10% above and 10% below also we will consider. So the release range is 0 to 40%. None of the unit must go outside 0 to 40% at L2 stage. We are considering an example, a 10 to 30% release in 1 hour. So at L2 stage, none of the unit must go outside 0 to 40% because it is written here, none is more than 10% outside and none is more than 10% below the stated amount at the final test time. If any is outside, then we will go to L3 stage. At L3 stage, again 12 units are taken. Average value of the 24 units, L1, L2, L3, lies within each of the stated ranges. Okay, not more than 2 of the 24 units, more than 10% outside, and not more than 2 of the 24 units, 10% below the stated amount. And none of the unit is more than 20% outside and 20% below the stated amount at the final test time. So at L3 level, mean of the 24 unit must be, according to our example, within range 10 to 30%. Mean of the 24 unit must be within 10 to 30% and not more than 2 unit must be outside. 2 out of 24 units must be outside range 0 to 40%. And none of the 24 units must go outside the range 0 to 50%. Okay, I hope you understood all these three levels.
Okay, now Pareto's three reciprocating cylinder. Assembly consists of a set of cylindrical flat bottomed glass vessel, a set of glass reciprocating cylinders, stainless steel fitting, screen made of suitable non-absorbing and non-reactive material, polypropylene, and a motor and a drive. The vessel is immersed in the water bath holding temperature 37 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Procedure: place the stated volume of dissolution medium in each vessel. Equilibrate the medium at 37 plus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Place one dosage form in each of the six reciprocating cylinders. Operate the apparatus. During the upward and downward stroke, the reciprocating cylinder moves through a total distance of 9.9 to 10.1 centimeter. Vertical distance it covers 9.9 to 10.1 centimeters, and usual speed is 5 to 35 dips per minute. Cylinder moves horizontally towards the rows of the vessels. You can see in the apparatus there are six different rows, so the cylinder moves horizontally in the different rows of the vessels. Within the time interval specified, withdraw a portion of solution under test from the midway zone between surface of the dissolution medium and bottom of the each vessel. Perform the analysis as directed in the individual monographs. Now, it is used for tablets, beads and controlled release formulations. Standard volume is 200 to 250 ml per station. It is advantageous. Gastrointestinal tract conditions can be easily simulated. There are six different rows, so in each row you can maintain different pH, as it is easy to make time dependent pH changes. Hydrodynamic can be directly influenced by varying the dip rate. Programmable to run dissolution in different media and at different speeds at the various time. Different media in different rows, and you can perform at the different speeds at the various times. Attempt to simulate pH changes in GI tract, pH 1, 4.5, 6.8. Disadvantages: small volume, maximum 250 ml, not suitable for dosage form that disintegrates into small particles. Surfactants can form foaming during the dipping. Media evaporation where the test is carried for the long. Examples: here's an example, drug release characteristics of different mesalazine products. Using apparatus, USP apparatus 3 to simulate passage through the GI tract. So there are six different rows. In this example, they maintain six different pH in six different rows. For example, in pH 1, in row 1, pH of stomach 1.2 and dip speed is 20 for 2 hours. In second row, pH of duodenum 4.5 at dip speed 20 for 1 hour. In row 3, small intestine proximal pH 6.4, dip speed is 15 for 3 hours. Like this, test is conducted in 6 rows. So this apparatus 3 is used to simulate passage through the GI tract. Okay, apparatus 4, flow through cell. The assembly consists of a reservoir and a pump for the dissolution medium, a flow through cell and a water bath. You can see in the figure four different type of cells. The flow through cell apparatus consists of a reservoir for the dissolution medium and a pump that forces the dissolution medium through the cell holding the test sample. The pump has the delivery range between 240 to 960 ml per hour with a standard flow rates of 4, 8 and 16 ml per minute. It must deliver a constant flow which is plus minus 5% of the nominal flow rate. The flow rate is sinusoidal with a pulsation of 110 to 130 pulse per minute. A pump without pulsation may also be used. Dissolution test procedure using a flow through cell must be characterized with respect to the rate and any pulsation. The cell is immersed in a water bath and the temperature is maintained at 37 plus minus 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, now the procedure. Place the glass beads into the cell specified in the monograph. Place one dosage unit on the top of the beads. Assemble the filter head. Fix the parts together by the means of suitable clamping device. Introduce by the pump the dissolution medium warmed at 37 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius through the bottom of the cell. Collect the elutes by the fraction at each of the time stated. Perform the analysis as directed in the individual monographs. You can see in this figure, first of all, 5 mm bead is placed at the bottom. Then 1 mm beads are placed. There is a vertical holder for the tablet. And the dissolution medium will be pumped through bottom of the cell. It is useful for low solubility drugs, microparticulates, implants and suppositories. Advantages: easy to change media pH, pH profile possible, sink conditions, suitable for poorly soluble drugs, gentle hydrodynamic conditions. Disadvantage: deaeration is necessary, high volume of media, limited experience with the use of apparatus, no USP monographs, pump precision influences the results. Okay, apparatus 5, paddle over disc. The paddle and vessel assembly from apparatus 2 USP with addition of a stainless steel disc assembly. You can see in the figure, the temperature is maintained at 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. A distance of 25 plus minus 2 millimeter is maintained between the paddle blade and the surface of the disc assembly. You can see in the figure, distance between the paddle blade and the disc assembly is 25 plus minus 2 millimeter. The disc assembly is designed to minimize any dead volume between the disc. Okay, now procedure. Place the stated volume of dissolution medium in the vessel, assemble the apparatus without the disc assembly and equilibrate the medium at 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Now apply the transdermal system disc assembly. The system may be attached to the disc by a suitable adhesive. The transdermal patch is placed either between the glass disc and an inert mesh screen or directly onto the stainless steel mesh assembly. Place the disc assembly flat at the bottom of the vessel with the release surface facing up and parallel to of the paddle blade and surface of the dissolution medium. Operate the apparatus. Speed is typically 50 rpm. At each sampling time interval, withdraw a sample from the midway zone between the surface of the dissolution medium and top of the blade, not less than 1 cm from the vessel wall. Perform the analysis on each sample aliquot as directed in the monograms. Standard volume is 900 ml and disadvantages, disc assembly restricts. Apparatus 6, rotating cylinder. The vessel assembly from apparatus 1 USP, except to replace the basket and the shaft with a stainless steel cylinder steering element and to maintain the temperature at 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Now the dosage unit is placed on the cylinder at the beginning of each test. The distance between the inside bottom of the vessel and the cylinder is maintained at 25 plus minus 2 millimeter during the. Okay, now procedure. Place the stated volume of dissolution medium in the vessel. Equilibrate the dissolution medium to 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Prepare the test system prior to test as follows. Remove the protective liner from the system and place the adhesive side on a piece of cuprofen. Cuprofen covered side down on a clean surface and apply a suitable adhesive to exposed cuprofen borders. Dry for 1 minute, press the cuprofen covering to remove the trapped air bubbles. Place the cylinder in an apparatus and immediately rotate at the rate specified. Within the time interval specified, withdraw a quantity of dissolution medium for the analysis from the zone midway between the surface of the dissolution medium and top of the rotating cylinder, not less than 1 cm from the vessel wall. Perform. Okay, now apparatus 7, reciprocating holder. You can see in the figure, the assembly consists of a set of volumetrically calibrated solution containers made of glass or other suitable inert material, a motor, a drive assembly to reciprocate the system vertically. The temperature is maintained at 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. The dosage unit is placed on the cylinder with release side out. Okay, you can see in the figure, dosage form, release side is out. The solution containers are partially immersed in a suitable water bath to maintain the temperature at 32 plus minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Okay, now uniformity of weight of single dose preparation or weight variation. The test is based on the fact that if the weight variation is not much, then it can be said that the amount of medicament will not vary considerably. Conversely, if the weight variation is larger, then it can be concluded that the active medicament will also vary considerably. Now, sources of weight variation are, solely depend on the pore flow property of the granules and filling of the dye cavity. Pore flow property results from improper lubrication, size of granule or adjustment of the lower punch. Okay, according to IP, weigh 20 tablets or 20 units selected at random. Calculate the average. Not more than 2 of the individual weight deviate from the average weight by more than the percentage shown in the table, and none deviate by more than twice that percentage. Okay, now we can see in the table, according to IP, if weight of the tablet is less than 80 milligram, then percentage deviation is plus minus 10. If tablet weight is between 80 mg to 250 mg, then the percentage deviation is 7.5. And if weight of the tablet is more than 250 mg, then percentage deviation is plus minus 5. According to USP, if weight of tablet is less than 130 mg, then percentage deviation is plus minus 10. If weight is between 130 to 324, then it is plus minus 7.5. And if weight of the tablet is more than 324 mg, then the percentage deviation is plus minus 5. Now, percentage of the weight variation is calculated by individual weight minus average weight upon the average weight into 100. Next test is content uniformity test. The test for uniformity of content of single dose preparation is based on the assay of individual content of active substance of a number of single dose units to determine whether the individual contents are within limit sets with reference to the average content of the sample. Okay, method. In this test, 30 tablets are randomly selected for the sample. At least 10 out of them are assayed individually according to the official assay method. 9 out of 10 tablets must have potency within plus minus 15% of the labeled drug content. Only one tablet may be within plus minus 25%. If these conditions are not met, then the tablets remaining from the 30 must be assayed individually and none may fall outside plus minus 15% of the labeled content. For example, 30 tablets are taken at random, 10 tablets are assayed individually, in which 8 tablets must remain within plus minus 15% and only 2 tablets are allowed to be within 15% to 25%. So the test has to be carried out with rest of the 20 remaining tablets, and these 20 tablets must remain within plus minus 15%. What is the conclusion? Out of 30 tablets, the potency of only 2 tablets may remain from 15 to 25%, and rest of all the tablets should be within plus minus 15% only. Okay, now thank you for your time and attention, and if you really like content of my videos, please like them, share them and subscribe to my channel PharmaGuide.